Hello students, and welcome to the final video of this lesson. In this video, we're going to be tackling a free response question from around the time most of you guys were born. This is going to be from a 2002 AP calculus problem, and we're just going to be looking at part of it, so some of the information given in the prompt will not be used. But let's get started. So here we have an object that moves along the x-axis, which is going to be something that we're normally going to be looking at. And the velocity of the object when t is greater than or equal to zero is given by this function. So notice here, what we want to notice here is that we're given the velocity function. So what is, in this first question, what is the acceleration of the object at time t equals four? So we're given velocity, we want to find acceleration. So what connects those two? So if we want a of t, well, we know that since we're given v of t, we just need v prime of t. So how are we gonna get v prime of t? Well, that's just gonna be the derivative of this function. So the derivative of sine is gonna be cosine of pi over 3t. And then we have the chain rule that we're going to be using here. So we're gonna multiply this by the derivative of pi over 3t, which is times pi over 3. Okay, so now what we wanna do is find a of 4. That's what we really want, okay? So as I do this, I'm just going to substitute a 4 in here. So I'm gonna get pi over 3. I'm gonna move that into the front, and I'm gonna get cosine of, really, since this is pi times t, so that's 4 pi over 3. So cosine of 4 pi over 3. And cosine of 4 pi over 3 is, let's see, that's on the negative side. That's 1 half, so that's gonna be negative 1 half. So I have pi over 3 times negative 1 half. Let's just simplify this out a little bit, and I get negative pi over 6. And that is going to be the acceleration of our object, and we don't really know what kind of object it is. It doesn't really matter, but negative pi over 6 is the acceleration at time t equals 4. And even then, we don't know any units, so we're just, that's our final answer. And it, even in the question, it doesn't specify if there are any specific units or to say like, hey, give us the units of measure, okay? So now moving here down to our second question, we have two statements. For t equals between 3 and 4.5, the velocity of the object is decreasing. And for t from 3 to 4.5, the speed of the object is decreasing. So are either of these statements correct? And for each of them, we need to provide reasoning behind it. Okay. So let's take a look here at statement 1. And to be completely honest, in recent years, in like the past decade, I haven't seen a question like this where you have like statement 1, statement 2, make a proof here. It'll have something like, is this true, is this false, and you have to make up a proof, but not like both statements. Now, I might be wrong in that. Maybe you will see a question like this, but from the AP exams that I've seen for the past 10 years that have been released or on our AP website as teachers, I haven't really seen a specific question like this. But it's still good practice for us to take a look at. So let's kind of take a look at this where, okay, the first question, the velocity of the object is decreasing. Well, really, all we need to see is within 3 to 4.5, we want to be able to see, okay, what does it mean to be decreasing for the velocity? Well, we're given the velocity equation, okay? All right, so in order for velocity to be decreasing, we need acceleration to be negative. Well, take a look here. We know the acceleration at 4, which is falls within the interval from 3 to 4.5. We know that the acceleration is negative, which means velocity must be decreasing here. So we'll say here that from part A, remember, you don't have to do the work again, but you do need to reference the work that you've already done in part A. So from part A, since A of 4 is negative, the velocity of the object must be decreasing. And we don't need to make any more specifications around this if it's decreasing over the entire interval. It just says the velocity of the object is decreasing. And so again, since we know that the derivative is negative, that means that somewhere within that interval, and specifically negative at 4, we know specifically within that interval that there is at least some frame of reference where this object velocity is decreasing. So I am just gonna make a specification here that this is true? Because we want to say, is each of these true or false? Are they correct? So now let's take a look at statement two. So we want to see, is the speed of the object decreasing? So what we want to think about is the derivative and the velocity, are they opposite signs? Because if they're opposite signs, that means that the speed is decreasing. If they're the same sign, that means speed is increasing. So we know information about the acceleration at 4. We have no information about the velocity at 4. So let's see if we can find that real quick. So we want the velocity of 4, and we're already given that function. So I'm going to just get sine of 4 pi over 3. And let's see, 4 pi over 3, that's also on that negative side of the unit circle. It's the y is going to be below the x-axis. And we get square root of 3 over 2. So that's going to be negative square root of 3 over 2. All right, so what I want to think about, all right, here we have this is negative. And the acceleration was also negative at 4. So since both of those are negative, so let me write that down here. Since v of 4 is less than 0 and a of 4 is less than 0, since both of those are the same sign, this means the particle, the object, whatever it is speeding up. Or you could say potentially here that the speed is increasing. I like to say speeding up, slowing down. That's a little bit more obvious in terms of how we speak English. But you do want to specify that they are the same sign. And since they are the same sign, we know that the speed is increasing. Now, doesn't matter if they're both negative, right? They're getting more and more negative, which means that the speed is increasing. We're not worried about the sign. We're worried about whether the signs are the same or opposites. And that's what tells us here. So since we know that it is speeding up, and statement two here said specifically that the speed of the object is decreasing, we know that that's not true. So we're going to mark this one here as false. And that's going to be the last problem in this lesson. You do have some homework problems coming up where you're going to practice more about position, velocity, acceleration. Really, they're just applications of f, f prime, and f double prime. And I hope that you find that what you've learned in calculus so far is actually going to be a little bit more applicable about speed. Think about how cars calculate speed. They're not doing it based off of, you know, long calculations. Like, this is, derivatives are set. You're able to calculate that very easily based off of what we've learned so far. And because of that, we're able to calculate speed of objects, you know, speed of planes, how quickly something falls, or, you know, speed of a rocket to the moon. We know how to calculate those things at any instant. And because of that, we're able to make a lot of leaps forward within science. Of course, if you don't understand anything that we said here in this video or in this lesson, please reach out to me. I'm Mr. Hernandez, and this was Mr. Hernandez Teaches.